something.
Hey guys, kicking in with the Cruiser here at the shop in Indianapolis, getting ready for our big race in Phoenix, Arizona this weekend. I just wanted to kind of give everybody some updates as to what we did last week, the first race of the season out in Pomona, California. We had a great time. The very first event we did was a really cool March Air Force Base visit with Colonel Max, if I get this right, Stitzler. Max is a good buddy, good race fan. We actually did an event with him 2 years ago in Dallas with the Snap-on crew, what we call the crew swap. And what it is our crew get to go spend a day with their guys and their crew. Usually it's the maintenance part of the Air Force base, which is really a cool thing. And we get to get the inside scoop on the engines being worked on and kind of along the lines of what we do with our Snap-on nitro funny car, the inner workings of the car. So it's really cool. We got to sit in some really cool planes. B-17 bomber, the big giant ones that has the wings drop down. It's just a phenomenal airplane. I got to sit in the pilot seat of that one. Our guys got to help change a flat tire, actually a tire that was damaged. Got to change that. Guys actually got to work on that thing. And just to see a bunch of cool stuff, we got to fly the ROV, one of the ROV planes. Kind of, it's an unmanned aircraft that's really cool. It's all flown by electronic, basically a computer flat screen sitting in an office. Guys were joking around. They'll actually eat a burger while they're flying this thing, and it flies like 70,000 miles up, 70,000 feet. 70,000 miles would be pretty far up there, but. But it's really cool technology what they have, what our U.S. military has available, and it's really an honor to be a part of it and to see this behind the scenes. So thanks to the folks at March Air Force Base, Colonel Max's staff. And on to the grill and chill. We did what we do on Thursdays with Snap-on. We usually take go and visit one of the franchisees or several of the franchisees locally there at the whether a dealership or body shop or mechanic shop. And this time we got to visit with the gentleman's name Rick Courtney, and he had a really cool machine shop down there in right outside of Pomona. I think it was Ontario. I think it was Ontario. Anyway, really cool shop. He had a bunch of old, I mean, we're talking old 30s, 40s mills and lathes. We're talking like the kind of lathes and mills that you've never seen in a shop. These things are like jumbo size, where they do pretty much everything and anything. He makes, matter of fact, he made a little part for this, the B-17 bomber, which actually is not even a bomber. It's a B-17 cargo plane. What am I talking, bomber? Although they may haul explosives in there, I do not know. But he actually made some of the little fittings that tie the cargo that they haul and tie down in this actual aircraft. So it was ironic that I was at March Air Force Base and was able to go down there and check out some of these machines that he makes. But great visit. We spent a few hours there with some of the local franchisees and families, and we ate the greatest street tacos. I'm a street taco connoisseur, but these street tacos give meaning to street tacos. They were so good. In fact, I'm on this diet thing. I went back there, I think I went back there for thirds. My sidekick Caleb out there, he was out there scarfing away, eating the hot stuff too. It was really cool. But we took this guy's card, so if we ever want to have a little lunch, maybe at the finals we'll bring these guys out and feed our team with some of these cool street tacos. They're really good. So we went on to the race. I want to mention John Marone, the Snap-on franchisee, the honorary crew guy for that weekend, or honorary crew person. We put on the side of the car, right on the side window of the race car. Great franchisee. I think he's 4 years into this system. Great guy. Had a good time. A lot of fun. And the race was kind of a crazy race. It was cold, which is why they call it the Winter Nationals. It was really cold out there, so we actually started out a little rough. We didn't make it down the track the first three runs, and then the fourth and final run, we were in the field. Boom, went out there and qualified fourth with a four flat at 306, I believe. The car dropped a cylinder down there by the finish line. 311 it was, yeah. So really, we felt like we had a great 3 second, maybe a 399, potentially a 398, depends on the speed, but car definitely was slowing down before the finish line. But a great run, not being in the field, it was kind of a Another signature moment for the Snap-on Tools Camry, and the team were, to say that we were happy was an understatement, because not only were we not in the field, it was a nail biter, because it was one of those times that we needed to run like a 4:18 or 4:19 or some pretty good run to get in the field. So it was great to get that run in there. Unfortunately, it didn't quite give us enough data to really understand what the clutch was asking for. Unbeknownst to us, it was not as smooth as I wanted to. I didn't quite see what I wanted to see on the one run, not having, you know, four or five runs to really look at the data. So we went out there first round and got the car, spun the tires, and then if some of you've seen on the video, we actually backfired the supercharger and almost blew the body off the car, but we were able to get it all fixed, get it going again. We know what not to do for Phoenix this weekend, so we're excited, looking forward to getting them back on the track. Everything's close to being rebuilt. A lot of my friends and family and even sponsor Snap-on people were asking me if my ears were okay, if I felt okay. And the only thing I could think of is the only thing that hurt was the checkbook. It really caused a lot of damage, but you know, that happens. When you have 9,000 plus horsepower with these cars, you're going to have damage. You're going to have incidents like that. So, but I really feel like this is going to be a great year for us. So I want to let all the franchisees and all the people that support us know that, hey, don't judge us off the first race. We're going to have a great season, and Phoenix ought to be a good one. I understand they repaved it, so we have some new surface there. What I like about new surface is you're not going to have a lot of these teams that have data on that particular racetrack. It's kind of a fresh sheet of paper. It's whoever can make the adjustments on the fly right there that weekend. So looking forward to starting off and making some good runs there. So thank you, guys. Hope you like this. Talk to you later.